Now let's take a look at the journal entries in a process costing environment. This is based on our example that we previously worked for RTA distributors. RTA distributors manufactures cell phone covers. Production consists of two processes. Prepare the journal entries to record the product cost for each department. In the molding department, raw materials are molded and cooled. Assume production cost incurred totaled $12,500, $5,000 for materials, $4,000 for direct labor, and $3,500 for manufacturing overhead. Cost transferred to the assembly department totaled $12,250. So to record the production cost incurred in the molding department for the direct material used, you'll debit work in process inventory dash molding for $5,000. You'll credit raw material inventory for $5,000. Now I've highlighted the only thing that's different from what you learned in your job order costing coverage. The only difference is that every production department will have a work in process account. To record the direct labor, work in process inventory dash molding, $4,000, cash or wages payable, $4,000. And to record the overhead applied, of course, you'll debit work in process inventory dash molding for $3,500, and you'll credit manufacturing overhead, just like you would have in a job order system. Now, to record the cost transferred to the next department, recall that previously, if you said that units were completed, you would have put them into the finished goods inventory account. But in this case, in a process costing environment, costs move from one department to another. So as costs move to the assembly department, we'll debit work in process inventory dash assembly for $12,250, and we'll credit work in process inventory dash molding. Then more costs will be incurred in the next department, that is the assembly department where parts are assembled and packaged. And assume an additional $5,000 of production cost is incurred, $500 for materials, $1,500 for direct labor, and $3,000 for manufacturing overhead applied. An inventory costing $19,000 was transferred to the finished goods warehouse. To record the costs of production incurred in the assembly department, you will debit work in process inventory dash assembly for the direct material used, the direct labor, and the overhead applied. For the direct material used, you'll debit work in process inventory dash assembly for the $500, and you'll credit raw material inventory. For direct labor, you will debit work in process inventory dash assembly for $1,500, and you will credit cash or wages payable. For the overhead applied, you will debit work in process inventory dash assembly, and you'll credit manufacturing overhead. So you can see that there really is no significant difference, except we have a separate work in process inventory account for each production department. We were told that the inventory was completed and transferred to the finished goods warehouse, and we were given that that amount was $19,000. Now we'll debit finished goods inventory for $19,000 and we'll credit work in process inventory dash assembly. Inventory has now been taken off the production line and put in the finished goods warehouse. Note that this $19,000 would include cost from both the molding and the assembly department. In other words, the cost accumulates from one department to the next, and more is added as inventory flows through each department. And finally, let's take a look at what you would do when inventory is sold to customers. What you'll find is that there really is no difference at this point. We will increase cost of goods sold and decrease finished goods inventory, In this case, it will be for $9,500. We were told that half of the inventory was sold, and we were told that the cost of the inventory was $19,000. We would also record the sale. We'd increase our accounts receivable and increase our sales, but you can see that I don't have an amount there because the sales price was not given. All right, this wraps up journal entries. So as you can see, the main thing you need to get from this is that inventory will have a work in process inventory account for each processing department, and costs will accumulate from one department to the next until it finally goes to finished goods and ultimately cost of goods sold. Get some practice. There's a few homework problems you can work, and get help if you need it.